Hey guys, welcome back. So this class, and actually a few classes this week, we're going to be really focusing on stabilizing this upper half, especially around the shoulders. So we're going to get straight into it. Start off in your comfortable seat, eyes closed down. You can be on your knees, you can be sitting with your legs crossed. That length through the spine. As like most of our classes, we'll start off with our exercises. Start to drop your right ear to your right shoulder, keeping that length lifting up. Just inviting some work through the left side of the neck. Take one more breath out. Start to move back through center, left ear to the left shoulder. Still that lifting upward. Gently, when you're ready, back towards center. Make sure you're really long through the spine. Start to look over your right shoulder, just rotating through the cervical spine, through the neck. Then when you're ready, back through center, start to look over the left. This whole time with all this movement, still breathing down into the belly. Back towards the center, start to drop your chin towards your chest. Then start to look up, chin towards the ceiling, allow the crown of your head to fall back. Back towards center. Start to bring your hands out in front, come into a tabletop shape. And because we're going to be on our hands a fair bit to stabilize the shoulders, we're going to warm up through the wrists. So just a few wrist push-ups, ground down through the fingers. Start to lift the heel of your hand, then lower down. As you breathe in, lift up, keep the fingers super engaged, then really slowly down. Just two more like this. Your thumbs are going to come up off the earth, and then slowly lower down. Just one more. Good. After that, start to turn your hands around so your fingers are facing your knees. Your thumbs are going to be going outward. Yeah? If you turn your hands internally, first off, that's pretty impressive, but we want to externally rotate. Good. And then just start to shift the weight backwards and forwards. Find your depth. With this, the further back your weight is, the more intense the sensation, the further forward, the more gentle. But just find what works for you, as long as you're getting some sensation through the forearms. But the fingers are still engaged. Just take one more breath. Start to turn your hands back to neutral. We will work through just three cat-cows, so move really slowly on the breath in, drop the belly. Tuck the chin, push the ground away as you breathe out. Now two more times like that, but use your breath as a guide for how long these movements are going to be. Try and slow it down as much as you can. And just one more. Keep that same engagement you had doing those forearm push-ups, wrist push-ups, as you have right now. Back to neutral on the breath in, then downward facing dog as you breathe out. Cool. And we're not going to get too crazy here, but we do want to start to stabilize through the shoulders. So make sure you're pushing the ground away. I don't know if you noticed what India's body just did, slumping down and then pushing away. There's a difference and you can see it. Keep the sitting bones spinning up. Now, like I said, we're not going to get too crazy, but we are going to work on some shoulder strengthening. Start to take your left hand back in line with your body, grounding down through the right. Now, if you want a little more here, you can start to lift that right leg, but this is really tough. Yeah? Or you can keep that foot down and just stabilize to the right hand. Take one more breath. Both hands back to the earth. Ground down through the left. Start to take the right arm back in line with your body. Again, this may be enough, or you can start to lift that leg. Yeah, this is a really tough shape. If you try it, you will see all of those little shakes, but it's really, really good for stabilizing around that shoulder joint. Slowly come back to center. Start to ripple forward towards a high plank. So notice how India led with her hips and up the spine, land in a high plank. Now, as always, there is modifications. Yeah, you can still work this shoulder strengthening without this full load of the body. Stay here if you want to challenge yourself, or if you feel comfortable, if you need, you can shift the weight forwards, drop the knees. India's hips are in line with the rest of her body. Keep the fingers engaged. Now, we're not going to be here for too long. We're not going to just kill the shoulders. We're going to take breaks in between. So take one more breath out. Shift the weight forward. Lower all the way down to the earth. Have your arms come down by your side. We're going to come straight into Shalabhasana. So head, chest, shoulders lift as you breathe in. Feet are going to start to come off the ground as well. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. We're opening up through the chest here, which when we're doing a lot of work through the shoulders, it's nice to open up that front. Yeah? We're engaging the core, strengthening all these muscles in the lower back. Take one more breath in. Lower down as you breathe out. Start to bring your hands to either side of your ribs. Push up through that tabletop, land in a downward facing. Again, let this shape land. Feel the sitting bones spinning up. Feel yourself pushing the earth away. Alright, from here guys, we're going to start to move into our flow. Take a breath out together in this down dog. Start to lift your right heel up towards the sky. Come to a three-legged dog. Take that right knee to the right armpit as you breathe out. Lift it back up, breathe in. Knee to nose, just a regular tiger curl as you breathe out, push the ground away. One more time, lift it back up. Now start to take the knee across your body to the left armpit as you breathe out. Extend the leg, fall in triangle, breathe in. Now here, you can have that foot on the ground if you need to. You can also have the knee on the ground. But no matter where you are pushing the ground away with that right hand. Super strong, super engaged, lifting this left arm towards the sky. Take one more breath in. Start to lower your hips towards the earth as you breathe out. Inhale, length through the spine like somebody's got a string lifting it up. Then fold forward as you breathe out. Land here. Now, just like any forward fold, we want to think chest towards the earth. Yeah, that's where we get the most work through the back of the legs or inner legs here. Keep your toes spinning up. Take one more breath out here. Start to lift back up. Plant that right hand. Fall in triangle. Breathe in. Tiger curl as you breathe out, so the left hand comes down, knee towards nose, step between your hands, crescent lunge. Now here I want everyone to focus on their upper half. Yeah, being really strong through the arms, trying to get biceps by ears. If you feel really bunched up here, same as downward facing dog, externally rotate the arms, have the palms face each other. That's going to give you more room through the shoulders. Take one more breath in. Warrior two, as you breathe out, this right knee stays. Yeah, that front half has stayed exactly the same position as it was in crescent lunge. All that's happened is we've started to square off, not perfectly, but the outer edge of that back foot is towards the earth. Arms are reaching away. Take one more breath out. Front leg stays where it is. Reverse warrior breathing. Plant the hands, chaturanga. As you breathe out, if you want some more, you can float this right leg. Up dog, push the earth away, downward facing. breathe out, we'll start to take it on the other side straight away. Left heel rises up. Three tiger curls. This first one to the left armpit. Using those obliques, lift it back up, breathe in. Tiger curl, just straight forward this time, knee to nose. Still pushing the earth away, puffing up through the shoulders. Down, three-legged dog. Take it across the body as you breathe out. Fallen triangle on the inhale. Again, you can have that left outer edge of the foot on the earth. You can have the knee on the ground, but you are pushing it away with that left hand. Trying to keep the hips high here. Yeah, we want to work through these obliques, so we don't want to just let the hips sink down. One more big, expansive, strong breath in. Drop the hips as you breathe out. Lift up through the spine first. Use this breath in for space. Then fold into it as you exhale. In here, leading with the chest. Letting it be the thing that gravity is drawing towards the ground. Take one more breath out. Start to work towards planting that left hand. Fallen triangle, breathe in. Plant the right hand, hug that knee in tight. Then step through, crescent lunge. Again, strong through the arms. Now you can start to think belly button in towards spine. So hips up is this nice straight line. We're not arching through the lower back. None of that. Straight. Good. One more breath in. Warrior two, breathe out. I'm going to keep that big toe mound on the left foot really heavy, but still thinking about knee in line with the toe. We don't want that to fall in. One more breath out. Reverse, reach up with that left hand. Plant the hands, stay really strong, elbows in tight through chaturanga, up dog. Pushing the earth away, opening through the chest and down dog as you breathe out. Really good. We're going to start to move through this in flow, one breath and one movement. You guys know the drill. Take an exhale together. As you breathe in, that right heel starts to lift. We're only taking one tiger curl and it's across the body. So right knee, left armpit. Fallen triangle as you breathe in. Drop the hips as you breathe out, lift up, breathe in. Fold forward, breathe out. Straight away, start to plant the right hand. Lift the hips back up, fallen triangle in. Tiger curl, pushing the ground away so you can step forward, crescent lunge. Remember, biceps by ears really strong through the shoulders. Warrior two, as you breathe out, now let them relax, reverse. Inhale, wheel the hands down, plant them, elbows in tight, chaturanga, push the ground away, up dog, in, then let the hips lift you up and back, downward facing dog, straight away, that left heel slowly towards the sky, take your time, then the knee goes across the body as you breathe out, fallen triangle in, then slowly with control, drop the hips. Lengthen through the spine, breathe in, then fold down into that space, breathe in. Plant the left hand, lift the hips in. Right hand down, tiger curl, breathe out, step between the hands. Crescent lunge, arms rise up, the upper half is light, warrior two, as you breathe out, just floating through the air, reverse warrior, like a plane in its flight path. Plant the hands, chaturanga, elbows stay in. Then strong, pushing the ground away, up dog, and then down dog on the breath out straight away. We're going to go again, lift the right heel, one more time either side. Then the whole breath out takes the knee across the body, fallen triangle, inhale. As controlled and slowly as you can, really good. Length through the spine, lift up. Then chest towards the earth, flow down, then flow back up. As you breathe in, plant that right hand, fallen triangle. Left hand to the earth, tiger curl. crescent lunge, slowly rise up. Maybe all of these movements, take the whole breath now, warrior two, land. And you don't actually stop moving, reverse. Length through that right side body, plant the hands, flow through. Now you don't have to do this flow every single time. Yeah, the option is always there to go straight back to downward facing dog. Left heel, one more time on this side. Take it across the body. Fallen triangle, pushing the earth away. Drop the hips down. Up through the spine, breathe in. Chest towards the earth as you breathe out. Ground that left hand really strong. Lift the hips up, use those obliques, then plant the right hand. Tiger curl, breathe out. Step through, crescent lunge, rise up slowly when you get to the edge of the breath. Already moving towards Virabhadrasana 2. Legs stay where they are. Notice how that lower half didn't move. Plant the hands. Flow through again. Maybe by this third time, flowing through, you're at the point where you want to go straight back to down dog. Know that wherever you landed was perfect. Slowly start to walk the feet towards the hands. Land in a forward fold. Give that upper half a little breath. But just like our down dog, you want to be thinking sitting bones towards the sky, hinging at the hips. Yeah, we want to lengthen through the hamstrings, head, chest, shoulders, heavy to the earth. One more breath out to release them. Then slowly start to rise back up. Make sure you breathe in when you lift up. It's going to stop you from getting dizzy. Start to step that left foot towards the back of the mat, coming into a wide-legged shape. Now, you may have noticed India automatically turned her toes in a little bit. Yeah. So we want to work towards. Make sure the weight is going down through the outer edge. When we turn the toes in, we're just relieving a little bit of pressure from the MCL, the inside of the knee. Lift up through the spine, breathe in. Then start to fold forward, leading with the chest. Now we have a few different options here. First one is you're going to take your hands, clasp them behind your back, keeping the shoulders engaged, opening up through the chest. You're going to start to bring the hands towards the earth. Now you are more than welcome to stay here. It may look nothing like India does in this shape. That is fine. When you come out of this, guys, really important, bring your hands clasped to your hips before you release them. Yeah, don't just release them while they're over your head. That's bad for your shoulders. You're more than welcome to stay there. The other option is, if you are familiar with it, a headstand. Interlace your fingers, that pinky, tuck it underneath. Yeah, take them around your head. Make sure you are pushing the ground away with your elbows. Guys, this is totally optional. Only go here if you feel really comfortable. Yeah, there is as little pressure through the neck as you can possibly make using your elbows to push the ground away. Yeah, notice how India's feet are actually back. She's using her core more and she's using her elbows to hold the weight, not her neck. Yeah, we want to take as much weight out of the neck as we can. When you come down, move slowly, land back in that forward fold. Really gently. Start to come back up to standing. Feet back together in the middle of the mat. Start to bend through the knees, sit down on the earth. So we're coming into Gomukhasana. First, we're going to start by taking the left heel to the right outer hip, so the knee is facing forward or close to. Make sure you're on both sitting bones. If you need to sit on a block or a pillow, go for it. From there, the right heel to the left outer hip, trying to stack the knees on top of each other. If they're not there, do not worry. Yeah? If you're feeling any pain or discomfort in the knee, straighten out the bottom leg. But we're going to start here, by lengthening through the spine, we have the option today for the shoulder variation. Now you can take either hand, but bring it up behind your shoulders. The other hand's gonna come up. Maybe you grab a hold of your hands behind your shoulders. Yeah, that's option. You can stay there or you can start to fold forward in this shape. Ramakasana, cow face pose. You may get enough in the outer hips just sitting up straight. Yeah, if that's the case, awesome, stay there. Just one more breath. If you're in the arm variation, release. Now you can get to the other side however you need to, but the option here is going to be breakdancing. Take your hands to the left side, spin to the left, and maybe, just maybe, you land in Gomukhasana on the other side. Always remember, guys, one side could be totally different to the other. That is perfect. Yeah, that is fine. So if you need to straighten the bottom leg on this side, go for it. Just make sure both sitting bones are on the ground. If you're taking the arm variation, switch sides. Sit up straight first, then gently, slowly begin to fold forward. Leading with the chest. Start to lift back up. Unravel the legs. Send the right leg out long. Bring the sole of the left foot to the inside of the right leg. Spin the chest so you're facing the right foot. Length up through the spine first, then start to take the chest towards the right toe. Just like any forward fold, chest towards toes is going to keep the sensation in the back of the leg. Using your breath to bring yourself back from any distraction. Just one more breath out. Slowly start to lift back up on your inhale. Plant the left hand behind you. Flash dance. Push the hips forward, reach back with the right, not here for too long. Just one more big breath in. Drop the hips down, switch sides, the left foot goes out long, the right sole to the inside. Spin the chest first to face that left foot. Lengthen up, breathe in. Start to fold forward as you breathe out. Wearing off as much as you need. One more round of breath. Fall in, fall out, sink down into the space. Then when you start to lift up, the right hand behind the right hips, flash dance, reach the left hand. And slowly back down. Start to bring both your legs out in front. Lay down on your back. Hug your knees into your chest. Keep the right one there. Send the left one out long. Start to drop the right knee over to the left side. If you want to adjust your hips to the right, you can. If you've never tried it before, I suggest it. Yeah? Totally different sensation. Allowing the in and out. actually show up in the spine. Space and the release. And when you're ready, move back through center. Take it towards the other side. Make sure you readjust your hips. Slowly back to center. Bring the soles of your feet towards each other. Supta Baddha Konasana. Knees move out to the side. You can have your arms down by your sides, or you can bring your arms overhead, clasping your elbows. Feeling a little more open. Start to send your legs out long, your arms down by your side, Shavasana away. Feel like you're in this stillness long enough. I mean to say, if you feel like you need to stay, stay. If you're ready, close out your practice, start to move towards a comfortable seat. Keep your eyes closed, get there however you need to, as slowly as you need to, but when you do land, in that seat, bring your hands to your heart in Anjali Mudra. A gentle bow of the head. A moment to acknowledge your practice and the practice of everyone else. As always, I leave you with what Maharaji left Ram Dass. Love everybody. Tell the truth. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you so much, guys, for practicing with us. As always, if you have any questions, feedback, please reach out, let us know.
See you soon, guys.